Hey everybody, how are you? Thank you for joining me. Hello everybody, how are you? Thank you for joining me. Feel Christmassy tonight. Thank you for joining me. I'm just trying to get myself together. I have had an extremely long day. I have had an extremely long day. Extremely, extremely long day. Come on in, come say hi to me, everybody. Hey guys, how are you? Marie, thank you for the video, darling. Hey, Duman, how are you, sir? I haven't heard from you in a long time. Good to see you. Hope everything is well. Marie, thank you. Hey, Elder Skinner. Marie, thank you for that video. It was so beautiful. I almost didn't know who you were talking about for a minute. Thank you so much for thank you for that video. It'll be on my page soon. Hey, Devon. Ooh, is this too loud? I think so. Hey, Demond, I need you to go on my new YouTube page. It's Darcy Burgess. It's the one with the blonde hair and the blue and white outfit. Go and subscribe, please, sir. Thank you. I'm doing well. I'm doing well. I'm doing so well. Oh, Marie, it was so beautiful. It was so beautiful. Thank you, Damon. Thank you. Hi, Elder Skinner. How are you? Thank you for joining us tonight. I have had a very, very long day today. A very, very long day today. Very long day. From like 6 o'clock this morning to just like literally a little while ago. From like 6:30 this morning. I am extremely tired. So I'm putting together my video. That's why you see me like this. I did my video. I'm still working on it, trying to get the bits and pieces together. Thank you, Duman. Thank you so much. I need subscribers. I need subscribers. I really do need subscribers. I need to post it on Facebook. I need to post it on Facebook. How was everybody's day today? This place ain't really that. How are you feeling, Demond? Not long you overcome by your presence, Lord. Welcome everybody. Come in, come in, come in. We're getting ready to get started in a little bit. We are definitely getting ready to get started in a little bit. We're gonna see what the Holy Spirit wants to say or do tonight. I don't have a clue. I honestly don't have a clue. But we know it's something because he loves us so much. And because he loves us so much. Amen, Demond. I am so glad to hear that, sir. I am so glad to hear that. We are so glad to hear that. But we know that God loves us so much, and since He loves us so much, it's His great will to come and see about us. So we know He's going to come see about us tonight because He loves us. So we're in great expectation to see what He's going to do tonight. Marie, how are you doing? Oh, Marie's in Maryland and Damon is in Maryland. That's right. I have Marilyn in the house tonight. Marilyn is in the house tonight. Oh, in California, Elder Skinner is from California. So we got East Coast and West Coast being represented again on the call. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Good, Marie. I'm glad to hear that. Glad to hear you're doing better. Goodness. I love that testimony. Oh, it was so powerful. Welcome, everybody. Come on in. Come and join us. Say hi. Say hi to me. Let's see where my glasses are. Say hi to me, everybody. Hey, how are you, sis? God bless you. Thank you for joining us, Sister Bridget. Thank you. How is your day today, sis? Please, thank you for joining us. Please share this video, everybody. I have people up here. I don't know where they went. Okay. Please share the video. Please share the video. Please share the video, everybody. Let people know to come on. I never do that. I always forget to do that. But please share the video and let people come on. God bless you, woman of God. Thank you for joining us tonight. Thank you so much. You're in Georgia, right? I don't know why, but I'm excited. I have an excitement about tonight. I have an excitement about tonight. I just feel excited about tonight. I'm just excited about it. Can you guys hear the music? It sound, I don't know if it's too loud. Hey, come on in, say hi. I don't know if people are having problems with their computer. Hi, everybody. Are people having problems with their connections tonight? Please let me know if you're having problems with your connection. We're getting ready to get started. We are getting ready to get started. Just bear with me. I'm just trying to wait. Yes, Georgia. Well, I'm in Florida, so we're not far from each other. We are not far from each other. Hallelujah. I think that I can do Periscope now. I think I can do Periscope when I'm doing this. I think I can. I think I can do, now that I have this little doohickey, I think I can do more than one thing now. I'm so excited. Okay, so listen. I'm grateful to everybody that is on. Thank you so much for coming on and joining me tonight so I don't have to actually talk to myself. So that's always a wonderful thing. So thank you. I hope everybody had a wonderful day. Like I said earlier, my day was extremely busy. I felt like I sat in one place for hours upon hours just working. But still, God is still good and he's greatly to be praised. So let's pray. Father, we thank you for the opportunity. Oh God, I feel your presence already. Lord, I thank you for today, God. I may not have been able to accomplish everything that I really wanted to do, God, like just sit in your presence, Lord. But I was able to accomplish a lot for my job today. So, Father, I thank you. Because there's somebody that doesn't have a job. So, Lord, I thank you for allowing me the opportunity to work, to put time in and work. Lord, I just give your name the praise and the glory and the honor. Lord, I just bless everyone that's coming on, that has been on. I don't know what's going on, but Lord, I just ask that you bless them, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I pray, God, that you will get the glory on tonight, that you will speak to us from heaven, from your throne room, from your sanctuary. Whisper in our ears. Give us what you want to say to us. We are open, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, our ears and our heart is attentive to whatever it is that you have to say. We give your name the glory, the honor, and the highest praise. In Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. Please, everybody, I see people are coming on. Just let me know who you are so I can greet you properly. Thank you for joining us tonight. Thank you for coming on. Thank you for taking time out to be with us. Listen, I am doing a couple of things. I want to get these announcements out of the way. I am doing a mentorship program, coaching program, starting in September, like the middle of September. We are doing a mentorship program for intercession and the prophetic. There's been a number of people that have reached out to me that says, hey, I want to know more. It's a one-on-one session with me, hallelujah, and we get some time, and I get to really pour into you and just share what it is the Lord wants me to share with you. So please inbox me. Let me know if you're interested, and just send me your email, and I can get all the information to you. I am excited because we're doing a two-day challenge. A two-day challenge, of course, on prayer. And what we're going to be talking about is how do you get your prayers answered? How do you know that God is going to answer your prayers, that God hears your prayers? That is the first day. And then the second day, we're doing something that a lot of people don't do, is talking about targeted prayers. It's one thing to be able to get your prayers answered, but there's a whole, how do we target our prayers? What do we say? A lot of times, we don't even take time to write down our prayers. Sometimes you might need to write down your prayers. So we're going to be doing the second day about targeted prayers and what that looks like. And how do we target? How do we hit the bullseye in prayer? How do we hit the bullseye in prayer to make sure that we can get our prayers answered? I am so excited about that. It's 2 days. It's a two-day challenge. Please come and join me. I have about 10 people that have already expressed that they really want to do this two-day challenge. So please reach out to me, send me your email, let me know if it's for the mentorship or if it's for the two-day challenge. Send me your email and I'll get the information. My page should be up by the end of the month, and all of the information about the challenge, about the mentorship program, is all going to be up there for you to review. Amen. And then if you guys have not had an opportunity to go check out my YouTube page, go and subscribe. Hit the subscribe button for my YouTube page. because I need somebody, I need people to subscribe. I don't talk about it a lot because I forget about it, but I need to really be more diligent on it. So please, please, please go and check out Darcy Burgess. It's me with my blonde hair and in this blue and white outfit. I say that because I have, evidently I have a couple of pages. But please, the one I'm talking about is Prophet Darcy Burgess, my blonde hair, and my blue and white, this beautiful blue and white outfit. Please go and check it out and subscribe. Listen, I just wanted to take time out to pray today. I have been, it's a lot going on. It's like, it just seems like a lot of stuff has picked up for me. A lot of stuff has picked up for me. And it's sometimes it just seems so hard to just get time to steal away because it's so many things going on. But that's why I'm grateful, because of relationship. I'm grateful that I have relationship with the Father, with the Holy Spirit, and the Son. And we can take time out to just talk to Him. One of the things that I believe my assignment in the earth at this time, is to present prayer in a different way. It's having the body of Christ see prayer differently. We've always seen prayer in certain ways, but I really believe that my assignment for this hour is to help people see prayer in a different way, right? How do we pray? What does it mean to pray? Is it like what our parents taught us, or is it something different? So, it's my phone. I never use that phone. But so how do we see prayer differently? So that's my assignment. That's one of the things that the Lord is blessing me to do in this hour, is to really help people see prayer differently. A lot of times when it comes to prayer, we are literally, sometimes it feels like we're being dragged into prayer, like they're dragging us into prayer. Sometimes we dread to have to go into prayer. And it's like when it's time to pray, we find a million and one things to do when it comes time to pray, because the enemy makes us feel that it's a tedious job. It's a tedious thing to do, to go into prayer. But in all actuality, it's not a tedious thing. It's one of the best joys that you can have, that when you can go into the presence of the Lord. Hey, Tia, how are you, sis? When you can go into the presence of the Lord. And one of the things that I believe that God is calling us to do is to take opportunities to find ourselves in the presence of the Lord. Why is that so important? It's so important because we need answers. We, you know, I talk about this a lot, that we have the Holy Spirit, and He sits in the presence of God. He's part of the Godhead, and He's in the presence of God. They sit and they take counsel, but we don't take counsel with the Holy Spirit. It's the funniest thing to me. We don't take counsel with the Holy Spirit. We just go about our day and we make decisions. And as we're making these decisions, we are leaving out the Holy Spirit. And we can't do that here at this time. We have to make sure that we are incorporating God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. We have to make sure that that's what we're doing. Amen. So I wanted to talk about that. I do want to get into prayer tonight. Hey, oh, bless you, Prophet. How are you? God bless you. I wish I could know how to split the screen, because I sure would get you up here tonight for you to help me do this, that you would help me do this, this Facebook Live. I don't know how to do it. I don't know if it's possible, but I would love to have you up here with me. Amen. But thank you for joining. Thank you for joining me, sis. Anybody else? So what I want to do tonight is I want to take prayer requests. Tonight we're going to pray. I just feel led to pray tonight. Tonight we are going to pray. And so if anybody has any prayer requests, people that you're praying for, If you need prayer for something, please, this is the time to really, really to put your prayer requests in, and let's go ahead and let's really just go into prayer. That is what I want to do tonight. So please, ma'am, please, sir, come and give us a prayer request so we could go ahead and start praying. Amen. Hallelujah. Father, we just thank you, Lord, for this opportunity to pray tonight. We stand up for Ramashande Bohosabaka. Hallelujah, God. Lord, we thank you. I just heard the Holy Spirit say the concept of prayer. There is a concept of prayer. I'm going to look that up because I just heard that out the blue. The concept of prayer. I want to see what that means. What does that mean? That's very interesting that I heard that. Give me 1 minute, y'all. Sorry, I got to download. I got to investigate my download to see what the Lord is saying about the concept of prayer. Concept. Let's see what the Lord is saying about concept of prayer. I just heard that. The concept of prayer is, wow, a plan or intention, a conception. The center has kept firmly an idea or invention to help sell or publicize a commodity. Wow, an abstract idea, a general notion. A concept is an abstract idea. Wow, that's really interesting. That's really interesting. A concept of prayer. A concept. Wow. That's quite interesting. A concept, an abstract idea, a general notion, are defined as abstract ideas or general notions that occur in the mind, in speech, or in thought. They are understood to be the fundamental building blocks of thoughts and beliefs. They play an important role in all aspects. Wow, the Holy Spirit is actually funny to me. He really is. That's why I love him. Hey. The concept of prayer. Amen, Bridget. Please put down your prayer request, whatever your prayer request is. Please put it down because we are going to pray tonight. I just want to deal with this, something I just heard the Holy Spirit say. Amen. I can show you. For real, please show me, Apostle Prophet Marie. Please show me. I sure will because I want to do it. And I just don't know how to do it. So please show me. I know how to do it before. Amen. God bless you, Stephen. Thank you for joining me. Thank you, Tierra. Amen. My sister Deborah is, I don't know what that means. My sister Deborah is Bridget Brown. Deborah Brown. Amen. I sure will. I want to deal with this word concept though, because that came out of the blue. So I want to deal with that real quick. And then we're going to go ahead into prayer. We're going to go ahead into prayer after I just see what the Lord wants to say about this. But please, please put your prayer requests in. Please keep putting your prayer requests in so we could, so we can actually pray tonight. But there's something that the Lord wants to say about the concept, a concept of prayer. And I want to just deal with that before I pray tonight. A concept of prayer. Prayer is in the Christian faith and in many other spiritual traditions, a way of being and a way of relating. Prayer is a way of being, wow, being in the moment, being present, being open. It is a way of learning to be ourselves. Prayer is a way of relating to God, to ourselves, to those around us. That's quite interesting, everybody. Very, very interesting. I like the thought because it talks about prayer and it's saying that prayer is a way of relating to God. That's really, really interesting. Prayer is a way of relating to God. Prayer is a way of being in the moment, being present, being open. It is a way of learning to be ourselves, a concept, the way we see something, the way we see something. It's so funny because we've been talking about Prophet Marie. We have been talking about perception. That's why I think it's so funny, because we have been talking about perception. And when we're talking about perception, it's the way we see something. And then now the Lord drops this and he talks about the concept of prayer. What does prayer mean to you? How are you relating? How are you relating to God in prayer? What is your relation to God in prayer? Amen, sis. I will definitely hit you up, because I need to know. How are we relating to God in prayer? I'm going to talk about this for a minute and then we are going to pray. I was getting ready to go into prayer and I heard the Lord, the Holy Spirit say this, so he wants to deal with this tonight. What is your relation? How are you seeing prayer? The concept of prayer. How are you conceptualizing prayer? How are you doing it? Let's talk about that, because I think that that's going to be good. Very, very good. Very, very good, Lord. Hallelujah. Many contemporary philosophers assume that before one can discuss prayer, the question of whether there is a God or not must be settled. Wow! That is a mouthful right there. They said a lot of philosophers that they have to, before they even like want to discuss about prayer, many people say this. I think that was powerful right there, everybody. Many people say this. He said this, we can't even begin to talk about prayer until we establish that there is a God. That sounds like Hebrew 11 to me, the sixth verse, that we have to first believe that he is. I love it. I love it. We have to first believe that he is, and then that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Prophet Marie, we're going to have to do that. What's going on is that we have to understand. I believe this is what the Lord wants us to talk about tonight, everybody. So I'm just going to go in. How are we praying? How are we seeing prayer? How are we seeing prayer? How is it that we can pray, but yet we have that question mark? Earlier, I talked about Peter. When Peter, the Bible says that the disciples were on the boat. They were in the boat, and as they were in the boat, there arose a big storm. And as the storm arose, all of a sudden now you see Jesus, and they see it. They thought it was a ghost. And he's walking across the water. He's walking across the water. And they're thinking it's a ghost. But Jesus says to them, be not afraid, it's I. And when he says that, prophet, when he says, be not afraid, it's I, the Bible says that Peter says to Jesus these words. Jesus, he says these words to Jesus. He says, listen, I know that's my lifeline. It's my lifeline too, Marie. Peter says to Jesus, Lord, if it's you, bid me to come. I remember when I was first, when the Lord first brought that to me, what he said to me was that, Darcy, you have to understand this. Peter said the word if. That is why Peter began to drown. He said the word if. If meaning, hey, Henrietta, if meaning, he says, if you're the Lord, if that's you, Lord, bid me to come. But wait a second. The Bible says Jesus yells out to them, be not afraid, it is I. So therefore, if there was true relationship, The Bible says, my sheep know my voice, and the strangers they will not follow. If there was true relationship, if Peter really believed who Jesus really was, if his concept of Jesus really, if he had the real true concept of Jesus, then guess what? He would have been able, he wouldn't have never started it with if. I hope y'all are following me tonight. We are on fire all around. Oh my. Yes, we're going to pray for California again tonight. This is good. This is good, Henrietta. I'm glad you're on, because this is why, maybe this is why the Lord wants us to do this. Because a lot of times we pray and we ask for prayer, but if we don't really know, or we don't really have a concept of prayer, a concept of who we are praying to, our prayers will literally be null and void. We can pray for California, but if we can't get believers to have a concept that God is a consuming fire, that is the only thing that should be consuming California right now, is the consuming fire of God. I believe the Holy Spirit wants us to understand, before we go into prayer, that we have to come, we have to settle the matter of who we are praying to. The concept of who God is. Is he really a prayer answering God? That's number one. Is he really a prayer answering God? Is he a God that picks and chooses which prayer he's going to answer? Or is he a God that answers prayer? In Acts it says that God has no respect of person. So if God has no respect of person, then could it be that, so would God pick and choose who he's going to answer if the Bible says that God has no respect of person? If he says that there's no respect of person and he's answered prayer for other people, then that means it has to mean that he will answer your prayer as well. I want to say it again. The Bible says he has no respect of person, meaning he does not have his favorites. He does not pick and choose. That's why we're talking about the two-day challenge that I'm doing. It's talking about, how do you get your prayers answered? How do you know, how can you know that you can get your prayer answered? Too many times we have had prayers out there and they're just hovering over, because we have not taken, we have the wrong concept of God in prayer. Our concept is wrong. Either we believe that he is, or we don't believe that he is. Either we know, because I remember, like, you know, we said we believe, yes. But it's a difference between believing and knowing. Do you know that God is a prayer answering God? The Bible says this, bless you, Bridget. The Bible says this, that even the devil believes. That's what the Bible says. Even the devil believes. Even the devil believes. I believe we have to go past belief, and we have to act, we have to step into the knowing. I believe that's why the Lord is dealing. I was about to just go ahead and pray. And the Lord, and the Holy Spirit was like the concept of prayer. I had to stop to find out what he's talking about. We have to know who he is. We cannot continue to approach the throne with a question mark. Peter drowned. Peter began to drown because before he got out the boat, he did not believe. Before Peter got out of the boat, it was already established that he had a question mark. How do I know that? He says, if that be you, bid me come. Jesus had already said, be not afraid, it's I. So why is Peter saying, if that be you, Lord, if that's you, bid me to come. But, come on here. That's it, Marie. We gotta really understand, because we're holding up our own prayers from being answered. I'm gonna say that again. We are holding up our own prayers from being answered. Peter, listen, before they were going to the other side, right before they were on their way somewhere, the Bible says right before that, Jesus just got through feeding the thousands. He just got through feeding them. The disciples had already began to see the miracles that Jesus had done. But yet, there's a storm on the water. They think it's a ghost, which I don't understand that, but okay. They think it's a ghost. But Jesus answers. He says to them, be not afraid, it is I. So people, you know, they say Peter had this faith. But if you read, if you go back to that chapter and you read it, Jesus says to the disciples, O ye of little faith. Peter, O ye of little faith. And a lot of people preach it, well, Peter had this faith because he got out the boat. No, Peter was an emotional person. Y'all know I'm telling the truth. Peter was the one that wants to cut off the ear. Peter's always moved by his emotions. Because it did not take Peter faith. Because Peter, listen, hear me. Hear me what I'm saying. Peter messed up when he said, Lord, if it's you. This is why we don't get our prayers answered. Because when it comes down to us really stepping into faith and really believing who God says he is, we have this little question mark. It may look like faith, but in the back, when Jesus sees it, come on here, I'm on to something. When Jesus sees it, come on, when Jesus sees it, he's saying, oh, ye of little faith. When we preach it, oh, Peter had this big faith. But Jesus says, oh, ye of little faith. Why? Because before Peter got out the boat, Peter had that question. Lord, if it's you, I am telling you believers tonight that we can no longer have that question. We have to walk in a place of faith. The Bible is God's word speaking to us. That's the Bible. The Bible is the word of God. God speaking to us. The Bible says this, a double-minded man is unstable in all of his ways. Let not that man think he will get anything from the Lord. I'm doing a Selah real quick. Because I honestly believe that we're living in a time that we're getting ready to see God tremendously answer our prayers. Prayers that we have prayed that have been held up. I believe that God is teaching us how to pray. I believe God is infusing prayer into the world so people can really know how to pray and really this time get your prayer answered. Why? Because God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he will repent. If he said it, he will make it good. Listen, it says this word. If he said it, he will make it good. God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he repent. If he said it, he will answer. He will make it good. My question is, did he say it? Because if he said it, he's obligated to answer it. He's not obligated if he did not say it. praying things and we're not lining it up with his word. We're praying because our emotions are pushing us. But outside of my emotions, what does the word of God say concerning the situation that you're dealing with? What does the word say? Jeremiah 1 and 12 says that God watches. He sits from heaven and he watches over the words that come out of our mouth. He's not watching out of our emotions. He's not watching for our sense of urgency. He's not watching for our cry of rescue, but he's watching for the word. His word. He's watching for his word to perform it. We got this whole thing wrong. We think if I come and I cry, if I lay prostrate, if I have a shut-in, I'm not trying to mess up anybody's theology. I'm just trying to say what I'm saying. We're doing too much. Is it wrong? No, it's not wrong. Please, I'm not saying that it's not wrong to pray, to have shut-ins. I'm not saying that. But I'm saying if we're going to have a shut-in, please have the right concept of prayer when you're shutting in. I'm not saying it's wrong to pray for the hours. I'm just saying have the right concept of prayer when you do it. Because we're going into prayer and we're doing things, we're doing backflips, we're doing so many things. It has made people not want to pray. Why? Because their prayers are not being answered and they are feeling, what is the use of praying? They're throwing in the towel because they have not seen their prayer answered. It is not that God won't answer prayer. It's we have the wrong concept of prayer. We have the wrong concept of prayer. We literally can't pray if we don't believe. I can hear you and you're like, oh no, Sister Darcy, I believe. But it's one thing to believe, but do you know? Ande boko, ramakinde nene boho satabakaya. Do you know that when I step into prayer, ikama yande boho satamakista mokondi asa remakure mandiba hasoko hosita bakaya? Do you know that when I step into prayer, when I come out of my emotions, when I come out of myself, when I stop looking at my situation and I step into prayer, I step into prayer not just hoping and believing. I am coming into prayer already knowing that he will do what he said he will do. It's all about his word. Come on here. We have to pray the heart of God. We have to understand we cannot pray our emotions and our feelings. Because Jeremiah 1:12 is clear. He watches over our words to perform. It doesn't say he watches over our tears to perform them. It doesn't say he watches over our temper tantrums to perform them. It doesn't even say he watches over our offering and our seed to perform them. He watches. God is looking for his word. He's looking for what's coming out of your mouth. That is why it's important that when we speak, we're careful about what comes out of our mouth. Because God in heaven, our father, our daddy, is literally, every time I open up my mouth, this is going to help us. Every time we open up our mouth, we have to know that God is looking for what's coming out of our mouth. That should help us a lot in some conversations that we're having. It'll make you more careful. It just hit me in the gut. It'll make you more careful about some of the conversations that we're having because of the simple fact that it's a new revelation that when I open up my mouth, God is looking. She's gonna say my word. Is she saying my word? What's she saying? Oh no, that's not my word. No, that's not my word. No, I can imagine God is like, well, when is she going to say my word? Eko masaba. Hina mandena da bokuriya bandi kosaba. God's looking. When are they going? He's looking, Jesus, when are they going to say my word? Because he's ready to perform. It's God's good pleasure to bless us. So he's looking for what's coming out of our mouth. But instead, doubt, confusion, fear, rejection, what all of this stuff is coming out of our mouth. And God is like, no. Oh, if they would only say my word, I will jump into action and perform it for them. If we would only say his word. If we would only know to say his word. God is literally waiting for you to make your confession. The Bible says, search the scriptures. The Bible says, study to show yourself approved unto God, a workman needed not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. We're to study God's word. Why is his word, oh my God, why is his word so important? It's so important because he's looking. Hear this. This is a consolban di ko shaba. Listen, God, I'm telling you, y'all was up here. I was getting ready to go into prayer. And the Holy Spirit dropped that word. The concept of prayer. Because our concept has to change. Our motives and intentions have to change on why we're praying. I said the other night, we don't pray, here we go, we don't pray the problem, we're to pray the solution. The solution is God's word. So if I'm sick, I don't pray and tell God, oh Lord, this is happening and that's happening. No, God already knows. He already knows what we're dealing with. So I don't have to tell him that this is the sickness or this is the disease. Oh, Henrietta, I don't know where your sister is. I wish she could be on tonight. We have to be a God. He is the word and he is waiting for to take hold of his words. He is. He really, really is. Him and his word, they're unchangeable. Read John, in the beginning was the word and the word was God and the word was with God. They're interchangeable. They're the same. I said this last night and it blew my mind. The Holy Spirit just reminded me. He just gave me a deeper thing. The Bible says in John 1:1, let me see if I could find that. Oh yeah. But it says in John 1:1, right? This is gonna bless y'all because it just blessed me when the Holy Spirit just said it. But John 1:1 says this. Sorry, I got my glasses on. I gotta find my glasses. John 1:1 says, I'm gonna read it to you. This is my Passion Bible. This is the Passion Translation Bible. I love this Bible. John 1, let's read it because it's blessed. It's going to bless me. It's going to bless you. And because the Holy Spirit just dropped something and we're getting ready to pray. I just wanted to just say this. I just wanted to read this. Amen. John 1:1. It says, in the very beginning, the living expression was already there. And the living expression was with God, yet fully God. The living expression is his word. So in the beginning was the word. The living expression. How powerful is that? In the very beginning, the living expression was already there. And the living expression was the was with God and yet fully God. They were together face to face in the very beginning, and through his creative inspirations, the living expression, his word, made all things, for nothing has existence apart from him. Woo, my God. The word is the living expression. I love how they just said that. The word is the living expression. The Bible says, you know it in the King James Version. I just wanted to read that because that's powerful. But you know it in the King James Version. In the beginning was the word, right? What the Holy Spirit just dropped in my spirit, and I said it, I talked about it a little on last night, that I used the reference of Mark 11 when Jesus says, if you speak to the mountain and the mountain will move, right? Speak to the mountain, right? And one of the things that the Holy Spirit said to me about that was this. This was so powerful. What he said to me about that was the mountain is not moving because of what you said. The mountain recognizes the voice of God, or the God on the inside of you. This gives better revelation to it. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God. The Word was with God. The Word was God. They're interchangeable. So when we speak, whatever we're speaking to, that what the reaction is because of God speaking through us. That is the reaction. That is why Jesus said, you can speak to the mountain and the mountain will be moved. It's the word. The mountain is responding to the God that created it, that's telling him to move. Oh, please hear me. Please hear what I'm saying, everybody. Please get what I'm saying. We see, this is the concept. We're missing the concept. We're thinking that it's us. No, listen, when the Holy Spirit lives on the inside of me, Jesus lives on the inside of me, I gotta understand that when I speak, the Holy Spirit is speaking, the Father is speaking, and the response is, when Jesus spoke to the wind and the waves, and Jesus spoke to it and said, peace be still, listen, he responded to the God part of Jesus. Oh my goodness, I hope y'all are getting this. The wind and the waves responded to the God part of Jesus. When Jesus raised the dead and he called life back into Lazarus, death responded to the God part of him. Now the Bible says, greater works shall we do. We shall do greater works. So when we speak, the thing that we're speaking to is responding to the God part of us. That is why when I pray, I can pray in confidence, and I can pray and say, I know, because that situation is, oh my God, it is responding to the God part of Darcy. I'm blessing my own self. Y'all, I hope y'all are enjoying this, but I'm blessing my own self, y'all. I am blessing my own self right now. It's a concept of prayer. When we have the right concept of prayer, we'll understand who it is that's praying through us. In and of myself, I can do nothing. But when the Holy Spirit makes intercession, when he begins to speak through me, my God in heaven. That is what is causing a response. The Bible says in the beginning in Genesis, the Bible says God said, let there be, and there was. I often talk about this, that in the beginning, the Bible says the earth was without form or void. There was no light. It was darkness. But listen to this revelation, everybody. God says, let there be light. So the word that came out of God's mouth, do you not understand? The word that came out of his mouth, the word had to find out what is light, because I have to perform light, because anything that comes out of God's mouth, it has to be performed. It cannot return void. So when the word goes out, then we don't know how long it took for light to come, because one day is 1,000 years. We don't know how long it took, but all I do know is that there was never light, and the word now has to go and find out what light is. I hope y'all are going to share this video tonight. I pray that y'all will share this video tonight, because God wants his people to know about the concept of prayer. Why? Because he's getting ready to really answer our prayers. And if we understood the concept of prayer, that when we pray, we understand how we are praying, we can conceptualize it. And then when I open my mouth, I don't open my mouth like Peter. I open my mouth like Jesus. When Jesus says, when he's standing in front of Lazarus' tomb, he says, Lord, he said, Father, I know you hear me. And a matter of fact, I know you always hear me. That is how, that is the concept of prayer. That I know you hear me. In a matter of fact, I know you always hear me. I know. Jesus didn't say, I believe. He said, I know you hear me. That is the concept of prayer. That what, when I pray and I speak something out of my mouth, the response comes. It responds to the God, oh, that's powerful. That blessed my soul. It responds. So when I speak to sickness and I decree and declare I'm healed, the sickness has to evaporate. It has to leave my body, because sickness cannot stand. If God is speaking out of me, and we know that the Bible says by Jesus' stripes, I am healed. We are healed. That means healing has to happen. That means, oh my God, please get this, everybody. That means that word of healing has to go out, and sickness has to respond to it. Sickness has to respond, not to Darcy, but to the word. God, the word, God, the word, because God now watches over the word I just released out of my mouth. And there must be a performance. Marie, it must be a performance. We're missing it. We are missing it. And we're giving the wrong perception to the world. Because our claim is that we have this relationship, and that when we pray, God answers prayers. But when the world looks at it, they don't see it. They don't see our prayers being answered. Because our conception of prayer is wrong. We have the wrong conception of prayer. We have been praying and praying and doing things, just doing things, with the wrong concept of what prayer is. When we fully understand prayer and what it really means and what it really is, it's how you relate to God. It's how you see God. I use that scripture when Jesus had laid hands on the blind man. He asked him, what do you see? The blind man says, I see men as trees. Then Jesus quickly lays hands on him again and says, wait, now what do you see? Now he begins to see men as the way men look to men. But when he first laid hands on him, he had a conception. He saw like Jesus saw. We're trees. Psalm said it. We're planted by the rivers of water. We're trees. We're strong. For a quick minute, the blind man gets to see how heaven sees us. They wasn't ready for it. So Jesus has to lay hands on his eyes again because they wasn't ready. It's a sad thing that God is ready to do something for us, but we're not ready for it. So now he has to touch our eyes all over again. Wow. Wow. It is a sad thing that our concept of prayer is off. So the millions or the wonderful things that God wants to do, he cannot do it, Marie. He can't do it because of our conception of prayer, our conception of who he was. The Bible says there were places that Jesus could not do many miracles because of the people's unbelief, because they had no concept of him. They had no concept of him. They still saw him as the carpenter's son. They still saw him as Mary's baby. So he could not do many miracles because of their concept of who he was or who he is. Flesh and cuz. But he could not do many miracles. Can you imagine that God wants to pour out? He wants to respond to our prayers, but he can't do it because we're still walking in belief rather than walking and knowing who he is. We use that word so lightly. Oh, I believe God. I believe God. We use it so lightly. We use that word so lightly. I believe in this hour that we're living in, God wants us to, the Bible says we go from glory to glory. Yeah, we believe, but do you know? Can you honestly say, I know? I know that when I step into the realms of prayer, my God, when I step into the realms of prayer, I am going to get my prayers answered. I don't know. I'm teaching all this now. What am I going to teach in the class? Lord Jesus, hallelujah. I'm joking. Because I know that there's so many, this is so deep. Pastor Gail, go hear this from the beginning. I was getting ready to end and just go ahead and pray. And as I was getting ready to do that, I heard the Spirit of the Lord say, the concept of prayer. So I had to stop to find out, well, what is the concept of prayer? And it talks about, first, you have to believe who God is. We have, and the word that it used, the philosopher used, it says that we have to settle the matter. Oh, God, I feel you now. We have to settle the matter, because until you settle the matter of who God, please y'all share this video tonight. If y'all never shared a video, please share it tonight. Until we settle the matter of who God is, until we settle the matter, We literally, literally cannot really pray. We can't pray until we settle the matter of who God is. We literally cannot pray, because we must, according to Hebrews 11:6, we must believe he is. Then you can believe that he's a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. But if you don't believe he is, then the Bible says, don't think you're going to get anything from God. I'm done. Please, one, share this video. If you did not hear this from the beginning, please go and watch the videos. Please go and rewatch the video. Gail, I don't know if you know Pastor Cousin Gail. I don't know if you know, but I have a YouTube page. And at night, I go in the discussions part. So it's the blonde hair Darcy with the blue and white outfit. Says Prophet Darcy. That's the one I want you to subscribe to. And if you go into where it says, not where it says videos, not where it says videos, but I put them in the discussion part because I don't know what I'm doing. But they seem to be able to upload where it says discussions. And I have all these different videos, all of my different Facebook lives. Please go back and listen to this. I am telling you, God is really trying to get prayers answered to his people. He's really trying to get our prayers answered. September, I will be teaching on how to get your prayers answered. Pastors, please, your intercessory prayer team, get them to be a part of this class. I'm telling you, our whole concept, now I'm gonna have to go do a whole study on the concept of prayer. Our whole concept of prayer is getting ready to change. And I believe tonight was the first part of changing our concept of prayer. I believe tonight was the first part, the seed to us changing our mind. A concept is a thought. We have to first renew our mind to prayer. We have to renew our mind. Our mind is not renewed. A lot of times, listen, guys, we are still thinking like the old man, especially when it comes to prayer. We are still responding like the old man. Yes, Henrietta. In order to pray the heart of God, we must have a confidence. And that confidence comes from, listen, it comes from the mind, your mind being renewed. It really comes from having the correct concept of prayer. That's what I'm naming this video. It's called the concept of prayer. Because the Lord really wants us to get this. I'm amazed because I was getting ready to end. I was getting ready just to go straight into prayer. And the Holy Spirit stopped me. Go watch it. I was about to go into prayer. But he stopped me and said, the concept of prayer. We're missing it. And God is getting ready. I'm telling you, every time I say it, I feel like there's like a picture being poured out. There is a marvelous outpouring of the Spirit of God. The God is getting ready. Picture a picture and just pouring out the picture. That is what God is getting ready to do. He's getting ready to pour out answers to our prayers. But we have to have the right concept. I am done. I believe that I said what I needed to say. I'm going to stay on this concept of prayer for a couple of days now because I know this is something that the Holy Spirit wants to get to us. So I am going to stay on the concept of prayer. Let's pray. I know that a lot of people, some people have brought, Pastor Gail, if you have a prayer request, please put it up there because we are taking prayer requests tonight. I don't know who else is left up here, but if you have a prayer request, please put it in. I know we are praying for California. Sister Henrietta, you said that the fires are around you. Is that the fires are around you? Please let us know what's going on in California so we can pray. So we can pray. But I know on the news it's been talking about those wildfires that are jumping off in California. I know, Henrietta, I am so excited. September's only a couple of weeks away. My page will be up before, and we are going to do, I'm telling you, I know that we're going to go deep into that class. We're going to go so deep in that class. Like, yeah, God is going to do something bad. Hey, Elder Skinner, God bless you. So Henrietta, as far as California, are the fires near you, sis? Are the fires near you? Let's talk about the fires. But please enroll in this class and email me. If I don't have your email, email me. This is going to be some good stuff. It's going to be some good stuff. I see you, Elder Skinner. Thank you for joining us again. Thank you. Please go back and hit replay. Oh, wow, you have ash everywhere. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, so Father, we know you, God. Nande Bokostaba. And Father, we have history with you. We know you, God. We know that one, you love Henrietta. We know you love Henrietta. We know, God, that your word says no weapon formed against her will prosper. You know, can one person stop judgment? Could one person stop the fires in California? Yeah, one person can. Ask Moses, he bargained God down. He bargained God down. Ask Abraham. He bargained God down. Moses, when God was getting ready to destroy the people in the wilderness, Moses stood in the gap for them. So one person can, Henrietta, your prayer tonight can literally stop the fires in California. So Father, we thank you. Elder Skinner, you're in California too. Father, we thank you. Where two or three are gathered together in his name, then he's in the midst. Father, we thank you as we lift up California before you tonight. Father, we draw a bloodline around the state of California. And tonight we push back the fires that are trying, oh my God, to take people's property, trying to take people's lives. Father, tonight we push back the fire. We put a blood circumference around the state of Florida, and we command in the name of Jesus, we decree and declare in the name of Jesus that the fires of God begin to push back. Oh my God, the fire of God push back the fire that's invading California. God, we know that you hear us, Daddy, when we pray. We pray in total confidence, knowing that you hear us and that you are answering us. Not even that you will answer us. You right now are answering us. We thank you that we speak to the fire. The God in us speaks to the fire, and we command the fire to be put out in the name of Jesus. We speak to the fire, the God that's on the inside of us that created fire, that is a consuming fire, now speaks to this fire and commands it to be gone, to blow out in the name of Jesus. Send a Euroclodon wind to blow, God, out the fire. Send rain from heaven. God, you know how to do it. I don't want to tell you how to do it. You know how to do it. Father, we thank you that right now there is movement. There is movement. There is movement. Father, we put a blood circle, a circumference around Henrietta and her home and her neighborhood, around the state of California. Father, for I'm even looking at a map of California, and I thank you for the blood line, the circle that is engulfing around California. And Father, we push back the fires of California, and we command them to blow out in the name of Jesus. Mountains, we speak to you. I don't know how the mountains impact the fire, but I speak to every mountain in the name of Jesus, and I command you to do whatever you need to do to block out the fire in the name of Jesus. We thank you right now that the fire is extinguished. We thank you right now that fires are being put out. Ande Boko Ramande Bokuta Messiah, that fires are being put out in the name of Jesus. May the consuming fire of God put out the fire on the earth. May the consuming fire of God swallow up the fire on the earth. I just need everybody to type in I agree. I just need everybody to type in I agree. We kind of got away from that. Please, let's get back into that. Everybody type in, I agree. That is how we do it on this. We come into agreement. So please type in, I agree. Father, we come into agreement that one person, one intercessor, oh God, will stand in the gap for the state of Florida and Florida, the state of California. And Father, I thank you that we have Elder Skinner, we have Henrietta that will stand in the gap for California. Thank you, Elder Skinner, will stand in the gap for California. And Father, we know we have given you back your word. You are a consuming fire. Consume the fire of California, that it will not last. But I just decree a blowing out, a fire extinguisher of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Bridget, a fire extinguisher. Father, I thank you, for we know that you have heard us. We know that you have heard us. Thank you, Henrietta, and it is done. We count it done. We thank you, Lord, because there shall be a manifestation of this prayer and all of the prayers that are going up before you concerning California. Sister Bridget, did you have a prayer request that I might have missed? I thought you were saying something. If you did, please put it down. If you had a prayer request, please, please put it down. I'm about to end. If anybody else has a prayer request, please type it up. Let us know, because I'm about to end. Amen. You are standing in the gap. Yes, you are, Henrietta. I'm telling you. One person, Abraham, one person, Moses, stood in the gap, and God changed his mind. God intervened on one person, one intercessor. It doesn't take a whole bunch. One person, amen. So I thank you. I thank you for you and Elder Skinner standing in the gap for California tonight. And we just watch God do what he do. We watch God do what he do. We know that it is done. We know that it is done. Anybody else has any prayer requests? Because if not, I am done. That's right. Glorify ministries. Father, we lift up Elder, we lift up Pastor Skinner's ministry before you. Father, I pray, God, that you will supply every need for that ministry. Father, I pray, God, that you would add daily such as should be added, even in the midst of this pandemic. Lord, let people find, search out the ministry. Let them search out Glorify Ministries in the name of Jesus. Let them search it out, God. Lord, open the door, open the way, God, that they can get to this ministry. Father, we bless the Facebook lives that are being done, that are being held. Amen. Yes, ma'am. That are being held, oh God. Lord, I pray that you will bless Pastor Skinner, oh God, and you will bless that ministry, Father, in the name of Jesus. And I thank you, Lord. I thank you, God, that he will grab hold of the words, oh God, that's being released on these Facebook lives, oh God, and that you will take him deep into this word, he will give himself to a study, and you will give him revelation in the name of Jesus. Father, bless his ministry. Bless his ministry in Jesus' name. I decree a blessing upon the ministry in Jesus' name. Father, we lift up Bridget. Amen. We pray for her to go higher in you and healing for her sister Deborah. Can you give? If you can, you can. If not, then don't worry about it. But can you give a specific of what we're praying for healing for your sister Deborah? If it's not personal, please share it with us. Father, I just lift up Bridget, amen, before you, Father. Father, her desire is to go higher. But Father, my prayer for her is to go deeper. Father, take her into the deeper depths of who you are, oh God. Lord, let her, oh God, get a perception or conception of who you are. Father, my prayer is that you take her deeper. God, take her deeper in you, that she will know what is the width, the length, the height, and the width of your word and who you are. Father, I pray, oh my God, I pray that the roots of the Spirit of the Lord will go deep down on the inside of Sister Bridget in the name of Jesus. Father, give her visions and dreams at night. Lord, give her to the studying, the studying of the word. I saw like a candle. Father, give her enlightenment. God, let the word, let her be enlightened. Oh God, let the eyes of her understanding be enlightened of the word. Take her deep, deep, deep in you, God, that she will know you, God, in the name of Jesus. And we thank you for it right now. We bless your name for it right now. Oh, God, I thank you. I thank you for a fresh anointing coming on Sister Bridget. Father, I just anoint her hands, that she can lay hands on the sick and they will recover. Father, I thank you, Lord. I thank you for the grace of healing upon her life in the name of Jesus. And even as I'm praying for her sister, Deborah, Father, I just pray that Sister Bridget, you will lay hands on your sister. Linda Makora Messiah. Listen, we have to believe he is. Change your concept. Change your concept. The Bible says that we will lay hands on the sick and they will recover. I charge you, Bridget, go lay hands on your sister. I lay hands where her kidneys are. And speak. Speak to it. Speak to her kidneys. And remember what I said. Remember what the Holy Spirit was saying. That when you speak to her kidneys, Bridget, you are not speaking, but the God inside of you are commanding her kidneys to be healed, are commanding the transplant to take, whatever it is that you need to take to happen, you speak to it, because they're going to, oh my God, that kidney is going to obey the voice of the Lord that's going to come out of your mouth. So, Father, I lift up Bridget, and I pray, God, that she will step into the confidence of believing who you are and believing that you are on the inside of her, and that as she opens up her mouth to speak, you are speaking for her and through her. So, Father, we thank you, because we know that you are going to do this for her sister, and it is coming through the vehicle of Sister Bridget. So we thank you, Lord, that Bridget, open up your mouth and decree and declare in the name of Jesus, and we count it done in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. We lift up Katie Chamberlain. She is a nurse in Hawaii who has been working the front line since March. Now she has COVID-19 and is very sick, right along with 9 other nurses. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, hey, Kamari, right now, in the name of Jesus, oh, Ramasoria Bashanda Babahaya, listen to Henrietta and to Bridget. Learn how to take communion. Learn how to take communion. Learn how to take communion. When you find out that these people are sick, take communion on their behalf. Henrietta, take communion on their behalf. Matter of fact, everybody go get something for communion. We're going to take it real quick. Go ahead. I'm going to go get my stuff. Hey, I'm gonna wait, but we're gonna take communion real quick. We're gonna take communion real quick on behalf of Deborah, Bridget's sister, on behalf of these nurses in Hawaii. We are going to take communion real quick. Those of you that can, go get anything. It doesn't have to be formal. Y'all know how we do. Get some. Prophet Lee said that she had some graham crackers and some grape juice and got a miracle. Okay? Go ahead. She has a new blood flowing. She has a new blood flowing. Thank Father God. I don't know what that means, Henrietta, but explain that to me. That's all right. That is all right, sir. You can hear us. Amen. But we're going to take communion. We're going to take communion. Amen. And we're believing, God. When you have it, just let me know that you have it. It can be a piece of bread. It could be something. Just let me know that you have it so we could take communion. Amen. And we take communion on behalf of you, Elder Skinner, as you're driving. As you drink, Father, bless his Bible study tonight. Let there be revelation like never before, Father. Open up his eyes that he will see like you see. Open up his ears that he will hear you when you speak. In the name of Jesus, God, let there be true revelation tonight in Jesus' name. If you have your communion, please let me know. If you're planning on taking it, amen, please let me know. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Ora Mashiach. And then I'm getting ready to go. But I do want to put this on our song. Amen. Our song. We're going to put our song on. Thank you, Lord God. Amen. We're gonna put our song on. Okay, ready. Bridget, are you taking communion with us? Just let me know, because I can wait. God bless you, Elder Skinner. Sister Bridget, I don't know if you're taking communion with us. Anybody else that wants to take communion, just let me know. If not, we're gonna go ahead. But this is our theme song. Ora masora bashandi. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, you ready, Sister Bridget? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Anybody else taking communion with us? I know Elder Skinner is driving. Anybody else? Let me know if I need to wait, because I will wait. Oh, I feel God. I feel God. I feel the presence of the Lord. I feel the presence of the Lord. Okay, we're going to go ahead if nobody else wants to take it. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you, Lord. Because you said, as often as we do this, do it in remembrance of you. So, Lord, we do this tonight in remembrance of you. We discern your body. We know. That's right. Take it for Lucy, Katie, and the nurses. Bridget, you're taking it for your sister and anybody else. Father, and we know that you hear us when we pray. We know that you always hear us when we pray. We know that we are discerning your body. It was your body that was broken. Your body was broken. It was lifted up and it was broken. And we know that by your stripes, by your wounds, Katie is healed. Lucy is healed. The other nurses that are in Hawaii are healed. Bridget's sister is healed. I am healed. Oh God, anybody, Elder Skinner is healed. Anybody that is going through any manner of sickness and disease, Father, we don't have to beg you. We don't have to try to convince you to do what you do and to be who you are. We take this communion because we know that this is a symbol of your body. And we know what your body went through just so we can receive healing. So we thank you right now, Lucy, Katie, Deborah, Darcy, Henrietta, Bridget, Elder Skinner, those nurses in Hawaii, God, those many people that I've seen on my Facebook page that's going through sickness, Pastor Les Lanford, I think that's his name. Father, I thank you, for we know that it is done in Jesus' name. Take and eat of his body. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we take the blood. We take the symbol of your blood. Because we understand that if there was no shedding of blood, there would be no redemption of sins. If your blood wasn't shed on Calvary's cross, we would not have the right to the tree of life. Father, thank you. Thank you for your blood. We know that your blood speaks. We know the blood speaks. It spoke for Abel. Your blood cries out. So Lord, the spilt blood of Jesus Christ is crying out for Lucy. It cried out for Katie. It cried out for Darcy. It cried out for Bridget's sister. I believe her name is Deborah. It's crying out for every person in the land. Your blood redeemed us. So we thank you for the redemptive power of your blood. And as we drink this, God, we drink it on behalf of those, oh God, because we have the concept of who you are. We have the right concept of who you are and what your blood stands for. As we drink this blood, we drink it because we are redeemed. And in the redemptive work of Christ on the cross, there's healing. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Drink it. Father, we thank you. We thank you, God. We don't beg you. We don't try to convince you. We thank you because you are who you are. You are I am that I am. I thank you for Lucy's healing. I thank you for Katie's healing. I thank you for Bridget's sister Deborah's healing. I thank you for the healing of those nurses in Hawaii. I thank you, Lord, and we know that it is done. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Right now, there's a river you come flowing. There is a river of miracles flowing. Thank you, Father. Thank you for the miracle of rivers flowing. Thank you, oh God. Thank you, Father. Thank you. Thank you. Come on, y'all. Let's just give God some praise. Just type up a praise. Type up a praise. Say something to him before we end tonight. Say something to him. That is also a part of the concept of prayer, is our worship and our praise. Our declaration of who he is. We declare that Jesus is Lord. We declare that he's a mighty good God. We declare that he is a prayer answering God. He is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. We declare it tonight. He is everything that we need him to be and more. He is the healer. He's the balm of Gilead. He's our bright and morning star. He is the lily of the valley. He is our strength. He is our strong tower. Everything we need him to be, he is tonight. And we give him great glory. Bakora Masiri and Bakora Messiah. Oh God, we give him great glory. We give him great honor. We are convinced that he has answered us. Father, thank you. Thank you so much for answering me for my campaign at work, that we win. Every election is won already. In the name of Jesus, I declare Okaloosa is won. I declare Orange County is won. Every campaign that I have on my job, it is won. it with little to no effort, victory after victory after victory is mine in Jesus' name. Why? Because God, you are my victor. You are my victory. You are my strong tower. You are my defense. You make me win. When it looks like I'm going to lose, you say I win. Greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. I am a champion. I am an overcomer. Therefore, I cannot fail. According to Deuteronomy 28 and 14, blessed shall I be. When I go out, when I come in, whatsoever my hand touches, it is blessed. Father, I thank you that whatever I step, God, where my soles of my feet will trod, you will give me the land. So I thank you that you have given me Okaloosa. You have given me Orange County. You have given me Miami. I thank you that I walk in total victory in the name of Jesus. And it is so, in Jesus' name. Amen. But you know what? You may not can see it, but you can speak. 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 Girl, you could lay hands on your own kidneys and decree and declare that as I lay hands on my kidneys, so the Lord is laying hands on the kidney of my sister. Come on here. You could speak to her kidneys right from where you are. The reason why Jesus had said this, the centurion had great faith, because the centurion said, you don't have to come into my house. All you got to do is speak the word. Greater work shall we do. Open up your mouth and speak. She is coming out the hospital tomorrow. Her kidney, she will take that kidney. Open your mouth and speak. Lay hands in the spirit. We can decree a thing. Open your mouth and decree. What is it that you want to see? Because what you see is what you say. You say what you see. Come on. Say what you see, Bridget. Say it. Lay hands on your own kidneys. Lay hands on the kids' kidneys. Just do it. Just do it. It's done. It is done. It's not if she's coming out, when she comes out. It's not you. It's the God in you that the word is responding to. It's not you, but the God in you, that transplant is responding to the God in you as you open up your mouth and speak and declare what you want to see. That word is going out and the kidneys have to respond. It's not a if, it's not a hope. It has to respond. This is the final thing that I'm done. But what was said was this. When think about it, read Genesis tonight, sis. Genesis, the first chapter. It says that the world was without form or void. It was dark. And the Bible says, God said, let there be light. There was never light before. How would the word know what light was? But the word had to go out. When the word went out of God's mouth, that word had to discover light. It had to find out what light was and how it was going to be created. When you speak to that transplant, that kidney, and you speak the word of the Lord of healing for that kidney, and that it will take, it will not be rejected, the body will not reject it. You speak to the body, you speak to the kidney, you speak to every area of your sister, you speak to it. And know when that word goes out of your mouth, there must be a response, Bridget. Because the word in you, the God in you, is speaking to that kidney, and it has to happen. It has to happen. And that's why we say what God says. He's watching. He's watching you, Bridget. He's watching your words. and he's waiting to see what you're going to say, because he's only obligated to respond and answer his word and his will, because his word and his will are the same thing. I love you guys tonight. I love you all. Thank you for coming on. Bridget, thank you for coming on. Henrietta, thank you for coming on. Elder Skinner, as always, thank you guys for coming on. You kept me company tonight, so I would not be up here talking to myself. Thank you so much. Please share this video. I really honestly believe that in this hour, my job, my assignment is to change the perception of prayer. It's change the way people see prayer and have us praying in a totally different way that we can now see our prayers answered. Once again, if you're free and you want to go deeper in this thing called prayer, in the concept of prayer, if you want to go deeper, send me your email. Just send me your email. Say, Darcy, listen, I want to be a part of that class. I have to be a part of that class. I'm going to do whatever it takes to be a part of that class, because I know that the Spirit of the Lord, bless you two women of God, the Spirit of the Lord is pouring out answers to our prayers in this hour. And we have to be able to tap in and receive answers to our prayers. The two-day prayer challenge, come and join me. I'm excited. The mentorship/coaching, one-on-one with Darcy. You get to have one-on-one with me. It's gonna be really interesting and fun, trust me. So we get to do a one-on-one. If that is something that you wanna just have, you wanna have that personal time where we can spend time and really just dig into the word of God and really hear what the Lord is saying concerning intercession and prayer. If that is your burden, that is your desire, by all means, email me. Let me know what you want to do. Is it a one-on-one? Is it the prayer challenge? Let me know. Pray, guys. I need you to pray. My thing will be up tomorrow. Please pray, saints. Please pray. Please pray. That my website should be up in a couple of days. Well, by the end of this month, it should be up. We are working diligently. It's like a couple of more things that we're trying to do. It's a funnel. It's not quite a website, but it's a new thing that we're doing. And I can't wait. I can't wait to see it. So I love you guys. What are you saying? Strengthen. Oh, bless you. Thank you for your prayers. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I know, Henrietta, I love you. Thank you, strengthen the woman of God in Jesus' name. I receive it, Bridget. Henrietta, God bless you as well. I receive it, I receive it. I receive all of your prayers. I receive your blessings. I thank you. Please, when you're in prayer, just take a minute. Just take 1 minute to pray for me. Please, saints, when you're in prayer, just take a minute. Call my name out. God is doing some great things, and I have to be in his will. I've got to be in his will. I don't have time to just be doing stuff to do stuff. I really want to be in the will of the Father. So please keep me in prayer. I love you. Tomorrow night, tomorrow is Thursday, and I have a meeting at 8 o'clock. So I won't be on until 9 o'clock. 9 o'clock, 9:30 tomorrow. If you're up, that's Eastern Standard Time, 9:30. Between 9 and 9:30 Eastern, it's probably gonna be more or less like 9:30. And I'll be only on for 1 hour, 9:30 to 10:30. California time, sorry y'all. California time, that would be 6:30 your time. And Central time, that is what, 8:30 your time. Join me, meet me here. Please, saints, meet me. I'm excited about what God is getting ready to do. I will see you tomorrow night. Love you, everybody. Thanks for joining us. God bless you. I don't know why when I hit this thing, it doesn't quite go off. I have no idea, but okay. I don't gotta end it. I don't really understand this, but okay. Here we go. There's a river.